Hello, today I'm talking about A Tale of a Tub by Jonathan Swift of Gulliver's Travels fame. It was published in 1704 and it's a satire about politics and religion and a slew of other stuff. The chapters alternate between digressions and the tale, but towards the end the digressions sort of overwhelm the tales, to the point that even chapters that are titled tale are actually just digressions. The digressions are kind of short essays about topics like criticism and the necessity for digressions in writing. They start off pretty sane, but then slowly kind of get a bit nonsensical, not to the point that it's just absolutely absurd. You could probably keep on reading them seriously and try and understand them, but it's satirical. They don't really have a conclusion. And then there's the tale. I will start by explaining the title because it's really hard to grasp otherwise. This is from the preface. Seamen have a custom, when they meet a whale, to fling him out an empty tub by the way of amusement to divert him from laying violent hands upon the ship. He goes on to compare the whale to Thomas Hobbes's Leviathan and the ship to the Commonwealth, and then he says that this book is supposed to be the tub, like the distraction that stops the politicians from thinking too much about serious criticism. So the tale is of three brothers. Have you heard that before? Yes, J.K. Rowling. She got that idea from this. I mean, probably? The brothers represent the three major branches of Western Christianity at the time. Peter, modeled after St. Peter, is Catholicism. Jack, modeled after John Calvin, represents Protestant dissenters. And then Martin, modeled after Martin Luther, represents the Via Media of the Anglican Church. So the story goes that when his father died, he left each of them a coat, and in his will was a set of rules and punishments for how to treat the coat. For example, in the will he says you can't have any silver fringing on the coat, but led by Peter, Catholicism, the brothers subvert the meaning of the will to sort of bend it to the style at the time. So if fringing or shoulder knots or anything were in fashion, they could kind of mold the words of the will to make that okay. At some point, Peter starts going kind of crazy and the brothers diverge. Martin sees the error of his ways and carefully takes off all of the ornamentation on his coat and gets it back to its original condition. Meanwhile, Jack, in sheer frustration with Peter and the situation, rips his coat to shreds while trying to get off the ornamentation. Swift meant this work as an advocate for the Church of England, trying to show it as being the sort of right interpretation of the Bible by showing the religious excesses of the other sides. But it's tied up in so much confusion and allegory and parody that doesn't really come through, and it just came off to a lot of people at the time as just an attack on religion in general. I actually found it quite interesting, which I didn't expect because usually I don't enjoy religious texts, but I guess the satire just brought it down to my level. Wading through the absurdity of the digressions was sort of laboursome, and at one point I thought, well, this is just proof that I prefer fiction to non-fiction because I'm just waiting for the tale bits. Obviously it's very biased, but I thought it was a very interesting look into what the branches of Christianity were in context to each other at the time. It's sort of like an 18th century Animal Farm, if you will. I raced through this quite quickly, so a lot of the sort of humour from the satire didn't really come off that well, but I'm sure upon a reread or further look into it that you really start to appreciate some of the content of those digressions. So I hope you've enjoyed this talk about A Tale of a Tub by Jonathan Swift. Next week we will be talking about The Social Contract by Jean-Jacques Rousseau. I hope you'll join me. Leave your comments in the comment box, obviously. Why would I?